So obviously a quicker turnaround than has been in years past for playoff games, but considering, you know, the way you played overall, not a bad way to be able to get right back into it tomorrow night.
Yeah, no, it's we got a couple days here, and we played Binghamton recently, so it's just kind of a review for our guys, and so we'll be ready to go tomorrow.
Comfortable win for you guys with them during the regular season at home, just a 6-point win. What was the biggest difference from this Binghamton team you saw from the first game to that second game?
Yeah, they're playing much better, you know, and they're an experienced team. Outside of Hartford, I would imagine they're the second most experienced team with a lot of grad transfers and seniors, so they seem to be playing with much more urgency down the stretch here. They went 3-3 in their last six, and then the other thing that jumps out, they're really shooting the ball well from behind the three-point line, and average, you know, taking close to 26 a game and shooting, you know, over 45%. So they're really shooting the ball well.
So how do you 12 threes in the last game? Yeah. How do you address that?
Yeah, I mean, we'll have to clean some stuff up and you know, when we played them on the road, it was the back end of that UMBC trip and the long bus ride, and we didn't have a lot of prep time for that game. So, you know, they did make 12 threes, but we'll have hopefully a better attack tomorrow.
Is Ben good to go?
Yep.
And is he going to be on Sessoms?
He'll start on him, yeah.
Yep.
I'm sure you don't anticipate the guys – you know, overlooking them because they're a low seed, but all you have to do is show them where that's going.
Yeah, right. Yeah, yeah. And the last time we played them, and, you know, we have to play every possession from here to whenever our season ends with a sense of urgency, you know, that we don't want our season to end. And so, you know, these guys have played hard all year, have been committed and focused, and I expect much of the same tomorrow night.
And what sort of things do you – try to review when it's the third time you're playing in the season?
Well, I mean, there's a lot of tape there, you know, to watch, and some things, you know, you can pick up that you did well on both sides of the ball, and you know, and make sure that we're prepared for situational stuff, and we have plenty of that, you know. So we had a really good practice today, and we'll have a shoot around tomorrow, and the guys hopefully will be understand the attack and allow them to kind of play free and just go out there and win the game.
Is Sessoms the key for that?
You know, I think on the surface that's the easy answer, you know, because he is their leading scorer, was freshman of the year. But I think J.C. Schall, you know, who came in with a big reputation after transferring from Bucknell's, battle injuries his whole career, he's really shooting the ball well, like 50-55%. Last six games of the year. And so I think he's been really good. Davis hurt us down there, another senior, and Stewart, another senior. You know, I think those four guys are the main guys. Sessoms has the ball a lot in his hands and has the ability to make deep, tough shots. And so he gives them kind of another dimension because of his one-on-one ability. But Chow and those other guys have been really vital too. Thank you.
So on the court, what did you guys see as the biggest difference in this Binghamton team from the team that you beat rather handily here at home early in the season to that tight 6-point game just a couple weeks ago?
I don't know. It's kind of tough to say looking that far back. We're playing a lot better at the end of the year, playing a lot tougher. Really comes down to just really executing and performing at the end of the year. I think we can't really look too much into either of the games we played before because the playoffs are a totally different story.
So what was the biggest challenge that they presented to you specifically in that game a couple weeks back on the road?
I mean, they just made some shots. They made us get out of our flow. There's some stuff that we'll clean up in our film we'll talk about.
So all season you guys all kind of talked about how you haven't reached your peak yet, or you're getting close but not quite there. How do you feel now that the season's kind of nearing its end?
it's really just you only know when you go out there and play. You can't really predict how we're going to go out there and play, if we'll hit our peak and at the right time or not. It's really just trying to give everything you got and do what you can for the team, and just try to give everything you have over, do whatever you can to win. And that's really all that matters at this point, not really worrying about if you're at your peak or not. Just if you're not at your peak, hopefully it's enough to win.
Great numbers against Maine, but looking back at it, any area you really want to improve or take a step forward in from that night?
I feel like I wore myself down a little bit. I think I could be more smart and efficient with how I'm scoring or how I'm getting my points and how I'm playing defense, and just focus a lot more on that end, because I know that's the most important part of the way we play as a team. And like, we'll eventually win a championship if you can lock down and really do what you got to do on defense.
You had a comfortable win on Saturday, and you got another low seed coming in here that you had success with earlier in the season, even though that was a while back. Is there just a message to the guys, the younger guys on this team, that you know, can't look past, can't overlook, can't anticipate that you're going to be playing on Saturday?
Yeah, they haven't really been here before as much as playing as much as like the older guys have, so it's really not, they can't really overlook anything unless you've been there and played in the championship game before type thing. So it's like, you don't really have to tell them much to get them motivated to play. They know, like, if we lose, we're done. So there's no nothing you really have to tell anybody to motivate them, other than if you want to keep playing basketball, you got to win.
Thanks,
Lynn. Thanks, Lynn. No
problem.
Thanks, Lynn.
So what did you see as the biggest difference in that, this Binghamton team, or the biggest challenge that they presented you differently in that game a couple weeks ago?
At that time they kind of seemed like they turned the corner a little bit, and since then I've been shooting the ball extremely well, and they seem to be playing with a different level of confidence that they didn't have kind of in the first time we played them. So they're like I said, they're really confident. They're, you know, they have a lot of momentum on their side right now. So I think we're gonna have our hands full tomorrow.
Is it a challenge when there's a team that is that aggressive in shooting the three? I mean, the three is part of what you do, but it's not everything. That you don't get caught up in that and have it turn into kind of a three-point shooting contest up and down the court.
Yeah, we don't. You know, we want to make sure, you know, offensively we're getting outside, you know, we're an inside-outside team, but it's definitely a challenge guarding a team that is shooting three ball very well. It makes it harder for us to guard. So hopefully we do a good job of limiting clean looks for them.
So where do you guys feel like you are as a team, you know, as far as hitting your peak or feeling like you're totally prepared to really take this one home?
Yeah, I think we're in a really good spot, and we got obviously the first one down against Maine, which is always good. We had a really good practice today and yesterday, and so I can't complain with where we're at. And I know myself and all the guys are looking forward to competing tomorrow.
With a comfortable win that you had over Maine and now a lower-seeded team, I mean, obviously they know that they beat Stony Brook, so they're dangerous, but they're still a lower-seeded team that had success against them. And the anticipation of what could be on Saturday, what's the message for the guys as far as just kind of maintaining that focus, not getting carried away?
Yeah, just you know, everybody can kind of start looking ahead and like, oh, maybe gets a tournament, whatever. So we just have to, you know, really tell everybody stay level-headed, stay in the moment, and focus on this possession and this quarter, or not this quarter, this half, and then obviously move on from that. But just staying level-headed, staying locked in into the moment.
Is that something though, kind of big picture though, that you've been impressed about this group, even with young guys that haven't experienced before, that they've been able to kind of maintain that focus throughout the course of the season?
Yeah, definitely. I've been impressed with that. And because it's, you know, the first time going through everything. You know, that's the first time they've won a quarterfinal game, so they don't really know what else to look forward to, but just to be in the moment. So, I've been really impressed with that.
Thanks, sir.
Yep, thank you, guys.
Good luck.
Thank you.